You call it a revolutionary driver assistance system. How is your software stack different?
Look, we are incredibly excited about what we did with BMW. It's been 3 years in development, focused on safety, and it's different for a number of reasons. I think the first one is one of the things you saw about BMW iX3, it's the incredible range. So when you talk about assisted driving and autonomy, you need to put server-class computing power in those cars, and with Qualcomm technology, there's no compromise. You have all the computing power, but you still have efficiency on power consumption. You can get incredible range.
Okay.
The second thing is it's scalable. It goes into every tier car. So we're super excited about it.
Cristiano, I've been studying the Snapdragon Ride Pilot, the SoC architecture, the software piece. This is highly analogous with the camera-based system that Tesla has, right? With FSD. You just talked about it being scalable for that reason. Did you benchmark against that?
So two different important parts. First, the architecture is scalable, starting from basic level ADAS all the way to multiple cameras and multiple sensors for you to do navigation on autopilot in urban environment and highway environments. That means it can scale to entry-level ADAS systems and entry-level cars all the way to the full capabilities. The other thing is, has been certified now in 60 countries, and it's launching, and a lot of people will be able to see the performance. Actually, we're super excited for people to see how it performs. And one thing that is great about this, we've done this with BMW, but it's available for the entire industry. Every OEM will be able to use it, and BMW and Qualcomm, we want that. And people will be able to see it, compare, and I think that's a great opportunity.
You know, my question was one of sort of an academic one, because it's the argument of a camera-based only system from an economic standpoint versus also including LiDAR and radar. But you're super focused on the compute, not just performance, but energy usage of the compute. Could you talk a little bit about how you engineered to that level?
Yes. I think the Qualcomm DNA, Ed, is it's about efficient computing, because we design all of our chips assuming there's a battery on the other side. It's not plugged to the wall. So I think you have the benefit of a lot of the Qualcomm energy efficiency compute, and you have the ability to get a lot of the computing power required in an architecture that actually incredibly efficient from a thermal management and from a power management. The second thing to fully answer your prior question is you do have the capabilities to do navigate on autopilot in urban and high environments, even if you have complex sensors or cameras and radars.
Cristiano, push us forward, because your real focus on auto has been one of diversification of Qualcomm more broadly. Of course, the auto sector has its trials and tribulations. How much is this going to drive growth for you, for the business in the longer term?
Caroline, that's a great question. Remember, we talk about our pipeline of $45 billion in automotive, which is kind of translating into revenue. We see quarter after quarter record revenue for Qualcomm, especially because it's not about moving with the size of the market, it's moving into share as new cars are launched with our technology. The pipeline is converting. And I look at this stack that we're launching on the Snapdragon Ride Pilot with BMW, is we look at that as an opportunity for expansion. In the $45 billion pipeline, one third of that is ADAS, but and it's included, of course, the BMW project. But now other OEMs can use it, and that's going to be upside on the $45 billion pipeline.
Cristiano, last night the president hosted a number of technology leaders at the White House. I believe you were invited, but unable to attend. And his message was very simple. Tariffs are coming specific to chips, but those that invest in America will be spared. How is Qualcomm thinking about that? You know, a lot of emphasis gets put on TSMC in Arizona, but is that like big enough to serve all of you?
Yes, it's unfortunate that we couldn't attend. We sent a representative, but we had the big party in San Diego at a stadium for the 40th anniversary of Qualcomm. And to your question, look, we're excited about that. Remember, we're a fabless company, so we need a supply chain that is resilient and in America. We like the fact that TSMC, which is one of our suppliers and investing in America. We like the fact that Samsung, another one of our suppliers, investing in America. And for Qualcomm, this is actually great news. We want diversification of manufacturing. We want more capacity in America. And we have said
before. Is Intel an option, Cristiano?
Not an option today. I think we would like Intel to be an option. They have been talking about moving to the next process technology, which they call it the one that comes after 18A. For us, we need a technology that has efficient power consumption. I think we just had this whole conversation on car. So if in the future Intel is ready for us, we'll be an option. Right
Thank
now,
you.
Our suppliers, really TSMC and Samsung.